This is a 15.6-inch gaming notebook. The box that it comes in is quite big with a lot of plastics around to protect the laptop from accidental bumps during transportation. This is not the slimmest out there, as there are laptops that are under 20 millimeters thin and weighs less than 2 kilos. There is a box within the box. Inside you will find the charging cords, and the charger itself is wrapped in plastic bag just like the cords. This is a relatively chunky and hefty 230-watt charger. It is about the same size and weight as the Asus ROG Strix G15 laptop's charger, which was very big and heavy at 770 gram, and this is something similar to that. The barrel connector is pretty standard, same as can be found in many laptops from other brands as well. This is what it looks like. There is also a 17-inch panel version of the Helios 300. Let's see what else is in the package. This looks like a cable for your mechanical drive, as there is an option to install a 2.5-inch drive in the Helios 300. One end connects to your drive via the SATA interface, and the other end of the cable connects to the motherboard. Acer also included some extra screws for mounting. There are 4 screws included in the bag. Inside this black envelope there are some quick guides and manuals. We are not going to need these now, so let's go to our main star of the show. I have to say it's been a really nice unboxing experience so far. The whole experience feels premium, and Acer has done a really nice job with the packaging and overall presentation of this product. The box that contains the laptop has a matte black finish, which doesn't collect fingerprints. It's got the Predator logo printed in the middle. 2 stickers hold the box together, and by removing these seals you will have access to the inside. The Helios 300 sits between Acer's cheaper entry-level Nitro series and the Triton series of thin and light gaming laptops. Acer has provided a nice little flap here which you can lift up. The laptop weighs 2.3 kilos or 5.1 pounds. Another layer of soft microfiber cloth protects the laptop from scratches. And now, as you can see, the Helios 300 has a very nice looking finish that feels very premium as well. There are 2 blue lines on the lid. This is not the cleanest design of gaming laptops, but taste is subjective. I think this design looks fantastic. On the backside you can see the barrel connector and the 2 exhaust vents. On the right-hand side of the Predator Helios 300, you will find some more ports and 1 more exhaust vent. It's a gaming laptop that will draw attention to say the least. Acer has gone for a futuristic, if not slightly over the top, depending on your taste, design of this notebook. Not everybody will like this kind of look. Some people will prefer a more clean, muted look. But those of you who appreciates this style will like this notebook a lot. The Helios 300 has a blend of metal and plastics in its construction. The shell is made from aluminum and feels very sturdy. The bottom cover is plastics. The rigidity reminds me of its closest competitor, the Asus ROG Strix G15, in terms of build quality. The Predator Helios 300 feels slightly warmer to the touch during extensive gaming sessions, as metal is a better heat conductor than plastics. This has an RGB illuminated keyboard divided into 4 zones, which can be customized in the Predator Sense app. The WASD keys and the arrow keys are highlighted. This is a feature I appreciate, as I use these keys a lot when playing first-person shooters. It also looks really nice in a dimly lit environment. The keys themselves are on the mushier side and not as tactile as gaming laptops made by Lenovo. Some people like more tactile keys, while others will prefer softer, mushier keystrokes. So this is a subjective preference. If you like slightly softer keys, this is a good keyboard. The plastic trackpad uses Windows Precision drivers, and they work well. Speakers on the Helios 300 sound like your average laptop. Not bad, but nothing out of the ordinary either. Like most Intel-based gaming laptops that have come out this year, the Acer Predator Helios 300 can be found using either an i5-10300H CPU or the 6-core i7-10750H CPU. There is no AMD Ryzen option yet. Perhaps Acer could bring AMD processors into the Helios line in 2021. That would be really cool to see. There are two physical slots inside for DDR4 memories, so you can run this at 2933 MHz speeds in a dual-channel configuration. In theory, up to 64 GB, although Acer only specifies up to 32 GB. Storage-wise, it has an NVMe SSD as primary boot drive, with the possibility to add a second 2.5-inch drive. Even if you buy a configuration that doesn't have a mechanical drive, the brackets are in place, and Acer includes the cable that connects to the motherboard as well as screws necessary to mount the drive. There is also a slot for a second NVMe SSD, so in total you are able to mount two SSDs plus a SATA drive. That's a lot of storage capacity for a laptop. The panel can be spec'd up to a 240Hz refresh rate panel. Panel brightness is rated at 300 nits, which is good. It covers 98% sRGB, 72% Adobe RGB, and 75% DCI-P3 color gamut. There is also a 144Hz base model rated at 300 nits brightness. This panel covers 95% sRGB, 69% Adobe RGB, and 75% DCI-P3 color gamut. No G-Sync on either model. The Helios 300 has a better than average panel for gaming laptops, and I would recommend to stick with the 144Hz panel over the 240Hz option, as they are very similar, and you can save some money by choosing the 144Hz panel. This panel already have good colors and fast refresh rate. With an RTX 2070, you will be able to run all modern PC games at ultra settings and still get a solid 60 frames per second. And in esports games such as Valorant, Apex Legends and Fortnite Battle Royale, you will easily hit over 100 frames per second. It will handle future games like Cyberpunk 2077 without any problem. However, you will not overrun the 240Hz panel refresh rate, so that is the reason I think choosing the 144Hz is the more sensible choice, as there are not major differences otherwise between the two panels. The version I have tested has the i7-10750H, 8 GB × 2 of DDR4 RAM, running at 2933 MHz, 1 TB storage, and a full HD panel with 144Hz panel refresh rate. Almost all mid-ranged gaming notebooks come with some kind of pre-installed app to tweak the hardware settings. In Acer's case, this is the Predator Sense app. You can access the app very easily by the press of a button. Within the app, you are able to monitor your CPU and GPU's core temperatures, as well as the overall system temperature. You can also set the desired fan profile for your laptop, so right now it is set to auto, but we can change it to max, which is the same thing as pressing down the turbo button on the laptop. The laptop comes with a 4-zone RGB backlit illuminated keyboard, ultra settings, 1080p resolution, and V-Sync disabled. Assassin's Creed Odyssey is a very demanding game on any hardware. Running this game at max graphics settings and in the laptop's normal mode generated 49 frames per second in average using the game's built-in benchmark. Doing the same test in turbo mode rendered 55 frames per second. So a good 12% increase over the standard mode. 55 frames per second achieved with an RTX 2060 is a very good result for this game based on my experience testing many laptops. Next game I tested was Batman Arkham Knight. Running the built-in benchmark resulted in 73 frames per second with max settings and 77 frames per second in turbo mode. About 5% increase. As you can see in the charts above, running the game in turbo mode also means cooler temperature for the graphics card. And this is because the fans are spinning faster in turbo mode, which improves airflow while maintaining better overall frame rates. Deus Ex: Mankind Divided saw a similar boost in performance. This time 66 frames per second in turbo mode versus 62 in standard mode, roughly a 6% increase. Again, we can see how the GPU temperature benefits from those extra increased spins. In F1 2018, I recorded an average FPS of 114 with the built-in benchmark at 1080p and ultra settings. Switching to turbo mode will boost this to 121 frames per second. So 6% improvement here. Far Cry 5. I got 90 frames per second in standard mode versus 96 frames per second in turbo mode, which represents a 7% performance gain. Temperature stayed in check for the GPU, but the i7 got really hot in this case, hitting over 90 degrees Celsius at times. Shadow of the Tomb Raider is a game I like to test as it pushes the hardware utilization, and with ultra settings you can see what the CPU and graphics are capable of. In this case, the Helios 300 managed 72 frames per second in standard mode and 77 frames per second in turbo mode. So 7% gain in average for this game. Total War, Three Kingdoms. This is a real-time strategy game, so it is not as important to get very high frame rates compared to, say, a first-person shooter or battle royale matches. The standard mode still managed to pull 53 frames per second with ultra graphics settings, and with turbo mode turned on, this increased to 57 frames per second. Almost an 8% gain in frame rates. This laptop will have no issues running esports titles like Valorant, Apex Legend, Counter-Strike, and Fortnite. In Battle Royale, you can easily gain more than 100 frames per second even with the RTX 2060 card and max settings turned on. There are a few areas where this laptop gets warm, particularly on the right side of the palm rest. When playing games, this area gets warm, but not uncomfortably hot. The major hotspot is definitely at the top section of the keyboard, close to the panel, which is why Acer has made some additional cutouts for air ventilation in this area. The keyboard area also gets warm, but not exceedingly hot during load. I measured 41 decibels in normal mode and 50 decibels in turbo mode, which is definitely on the high side for gaming laptops. This is very loud, and at this point I'd recommend play with a set of headphones over the built-in speakers. Battery life is a weak point of this laptop. With a 59 watt-hour battery and an Intel Core i7 inside the Helios 300, you will burn through the battery quickly. Streaming a YouTube video at 50% screen brightness only lasted me 2 hours 30 minutes. Playing an online battle royale match in Fortnite lasted only 75 minutes. In either case, this is well below the average compared with all gaming laptops I have tested so far on the channel. Stay close to a wall socket if you plan to use this device for an extensive period of time. Speaking of sockets, another thing I like about the Helios 300 is that Acer has put the charging port on the rear side of the laptop. In my opinion, this is the optimum place to put the charging connector as it doesn't get in the way if you have other peripherals connected. On the left-hand side, you will find the Kensington lock, gigabit Ethernet port, two USB 3.2 Gen 1 Type-A ports, and audio combo jack. On the right-hand side, you will find a USB 3.2 Gen 2 Type-C port with USB-C charging, a USB 3.2 Gen 2 Type-A port, a full-sized HDMI port, and a display port. A 720p HD webcam is located in the middle of the display. This makes the frame thicker than what it needs to be otherwise. The quality of the webcam is like most gaming laptops, that is to say sufficient, but not good in terms of the actual image. This brings us to the conclusion of the Acer Predator Helios 300. I think the laptop is for users who appreciate the specific design of this laptop. The performance is good, especially with the included turbo mode and the easy access to enable it via the dedicated button. The SSD is very fast. I'd recommend to get at least 512GB SSD as your primary boot disk. Should you run out of space, there is always the option to expand the storage via a secondary M.2 NVMe or a 2.5-inch mechanical drive. The display is above average for the category, and I think the 144Hz option is the sweet spot for your hard-earned cash. However, due to the relatively short battery life, I consider this more of a desktop replacement type of laptop that sits on your desk, as you will need to be close to a wall socket most of the time. Also, the 230-watt power adapter is huge and will add a lot of weight to carry around with. Playing games on turbo mode does get quite loud, so a pair of headphones would be recommended during long gaming sessions. That concludes this review. I've got a super exciting product coming up in my next video, so make sure you are subscribed and turn on the bell notifications to bookmark this channel. Thumbs if you liked this video. If you have any thoughts on this laptop, feel free to post them in the comments. This is Gen X Reviews, and as always, I will see you in the next video. Take care.